I'm going to tell you one more idea that's just been released in the last 2 weeks. These are the first steps to building a registry. If you go to my blog, which of course you should do every single day at least 3 times, you'll see now on the left side there's this CC Network. CC Network is something we just launched that anybody can join. CC Network, you get a ID and you can begin to register your Creative Commons licensed works. And this is the beginning of building an interoperable worldwide registry of creative works so that you can begin to identify in a simple, low-cost way who the owners of creative work are. But the interesting point right now about this CC network is that we give you a CC Open ID, which, as you know, is an increasingly standard, ubiquitous form of getting access to different sites, having a common ID structure. So that Open ID becomes your tool to get access to any number of sites associating yourself back with the CC project, and also enabling us to help build what I think is going to be the most important contribution we can make in this space, rebuilding a registry to make it easier for people to identify who owns what. So that's the objective of this project so far. We have 2 things we try to do. We want to make this copyright system make sense and to express respect for the creator. 2 things, sense and respect, where respect means respecting the creative work of all kinds of creators, both amateurs and professionals. Now, we come here to launch this project of CC Hong Kong in a time, in a debate around copyright of what we could call extreme uncertainty. And that uncertainty has been produced by a certain extremism in the debate around copyright. On one side of this extremist debate, there are forces who insist in the all rights reserved model of copyright, where every single use requires permission from the copyright owner, and they have the right to veto and control every single use. Against that vision of copyright, there's another vision, increasingly a no-rights respected vision of copyright, where people increasingly, abolitionists, believe copyright should just be eliminated. There's no reason to have copyright in a digital age. Now, Creative Commons stands between these two extremes. We believe in a copyright system, but one that is balanced, one that makes sense of digital technologies and respects the opportunity and creativity of creators. So this is a copyright system that makes sense in a digital age. Now, by being part of this launch, you are helping advance this balanced project. You teach and show and practice the ethic of this project by participating in making this part of the CC International world come alive, by expressing a system that makes sense in a digital age and expresses respect for the creator. Now, I've come here from San Francisco, first and most importantly, to welcome you to this project, to welcome you to the 50 other projects around the world, and to welcome you to the millions who have joined to help make creativity easier in the digital age. But I also came here, most importantly, to thank you. To thank you for helping us make this make sense. Because the more countries around the world that take this step, that adopt this project, that express this balance, this respect and sense, the easier it is for us to begin to convince policymakers that this system has got to evolve to move into the 21st century. So I want to thank you. And I discovered it's kind of hard to thank you in Cantonese. It was a little bit ambiguous which way I thank you. So I have to thank you in both ways. I first have to thank you for this gift, right? And I have to thank you for the extraordinary service you've done to the world in the way in which you have joined this project. Thank you very much.